Assalamu alaikum. This is your brother Rayan, Arab, recording for the Daily Reminder. There are things that Allah loves and we always talk about them, but what are the things that Allah hates? We have to know what these things are as well so that we don't fall into them. One thing is not keeping your word or not keeping your promise. You say to your friend, I'm going to meet you today at 2 p.m. and 2 p.m. comes and you don't meet your friend. Why? Because you got busy with something else and you forgot, or you didn't really care. You just said it with no meaning. You didn't mean what you were saying. Is this an issue? This is an issue. Is this what Allah loves? No, it isn't. Allah hates this the most. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَا تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ كَبُرَ مَقْتًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ O you who believe, why do you say that which you do not do? It is the most hated to Allah that you say that which you do not do. You tell your friend you're going to meet him at 2 o'clock, you meet the man at 2 o'clock. If you cannot meet him for any reason, then you can call him and tell him, listen, I'm busy, I can't meet you, I have something to do, please forgive me. He says, I forgive you, then you ask Allah, oh Allah, please forgive me, I promised this man something but I am unable to fulfill it, please forgive me, and Allah will forgive you as well. It is a sign of hypocrisy when you make a promise and you do not fulfill it, and when you do not keep your word. It is a sign of hypocrisy. Hypocrisy is when you show belief, but inside you are a disbeliever. And a sign of a hypocrite is that he doesn't keep his word. Make sure that next time somebody asks you for something and you tell him okay and you agree, then you make sure that you do that thing, whatever it is, you make sure that you do it. And if for any reason you are unable to do it, then you call the person, you say, I'm sorry, I am unable to do it. It is beyond my scope of capacity. Please pardon me. And the person will pardon you, and Allah will pardon you as well. Let me just give you an image into your minds of a story of Umar ibn Khattab and a murderer. One day, two brothers brought a man to Umar ibn Khattab and they said, oh Prince of Believers, please execute this man. Umar ibn Khattab said, why? They said that he killed our father. Umar ibn Khattab said, is this true? The man said, yes, I did. Umar ibn Khattab asked him why. He said, oh Prince of Believers, their father was standing on my land. I told him to leave, but he didn't leave. So I threw a stone on his head and he fell down and he died. So then Umar ibn Khattab said, execution. This man is to be executed. So then the man begged. He said, oh Prince of Believers, please let me go back and say goodbye to my family. Please let me say goodbye to my family. Do not execute me, oh Prince of Believers. So Umar ibn Khattab said, will you pardon him? To the two sons, will you pardon him? They said, no, we're not going to pardon him. Umar ibn Khattab asked the crowd, will anybody take responsibility if I let this man go and say goodbye to his family? One man named Abu Dharr, he raised his hand. He said, I will take responsibility. I will take responsibility. Let him go. So then the man went back to his family and he said goodbyes and everything. One day passed, he didn't show up. Another day passed, he didn't show up. The third day passed and then he showed up. He showed up a bit late and everybody was looking and everybody was nervous and worried and waiting for him to come. So then Umar ibn Khattab asked him, he told him, why did you come? Had you not showed up, we would have never found you. The man said, oh Prince of Believers, I didn't come here today because I fear you. I came here today because I gave you a word and I fear the Almighty Allah. So the two sons of the person who was murdered, they said, oh Umar ibn Khattab, oh Prince of Believers, we pardon this man. This man was pardoned and he was no longer to be executed. He was not executed, subhanAllah. What a bounty from the Almighty Allah. By what? By keeping your word. Keep your word. Allah takes you out of difficult times. Keep your word. Keep your promise. It is very important because Allah Azza wa Jal hates it when you don't. He hates it. He hates that action. He asks you, oh you who believe, why do you say that which you do not do? It is the most hated to Allah that you say that which you do not do. Don't say that which you do not do. If you get a call at 8 o'clock and your boss says, I want you to submit them papers at 2 p.m. and you're like, oh boss, 2 p.m. All right, I can submit them at 2 p.m. Then make sure that you submit them papers at 2 p.m. Otherwise, you are in trouble with Allah if you do not fulfill your promise. And that is a sign of hypocrisy. Keep your word. Keep your promise. Allah will help you. He will open gates of goodness for you. He will increase your faith and He will give you more of His bounties. Thank you very much for listening. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
كما ضمت مني